हेलो एवरीवन, आई एम संतोष केजी, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर, डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ मैकेनिकल इंजीनियरिंग, एमआईटी, मैसूर. इन द लास्ट सेशन वी डिस्कस्ड हाउ वी कैन डिराइव द एक्सप्रेशन फॉर द टैंजेंशियल स्ट्रेस एंड द नॉर्मल स्ट्रेस दैट आर एक्टिंग ऑन एन इंक्लाइंड प्लेन व्हेन ए बॉडी इज सब्जेक्टेड टू ए बायएक्सियल स्ट्रेस विद ए शियर. एंड वी फाउंड दैट सपोज If I take an example of a biaxial stress system with a shear, this diagram represents the example for that system. So here, if you consider this diagram, the body will be subjected to a normal stress sigma x and a normal stress sigma y and a shear stress tau. So in this biaxial shear stress system with shear, if I consider an plane which is inclined with respect to the vertical at an angle theta, on this plane we found that the normal stress acting will be equal to sigma x plus sigma y by 2 plus sigma x minus sigma y by 2 into cos of 2 theta plus tau into sine of 2 theta. So this equation represents the expression for the normal stress that is acting on an inclined plane BE, which is inclined at an angular theta with respect to the vertical line. Here we can say that sigma n, it depends on the normal stress sigma x and the normal stress sigma y and the shear stress tau, and also the angle of inclination of the plane theta. Similarly, we derived the expression for the tangential stress that is acting on inclined plane, which we have denoted it as tau t, and we found that the tau t is equal to sigma x minus sigma y by 2 into sine of 2 theta minus tau into cos of 2 theta. So this is the expression for the tangential stress that will be acting on an inclined plane when a member is subjected to a biaxial stress system with shear. And you can observe that the value of tau t, it is also depending on the normal stress sigma x and the normal stress sigma y and the shear stress tau and the angle of inclination of the plane with respect to the vertical, which is theta. Now, if you observe these two equations, here we can vary the value of sigma n. So the value of sigma n, it can be varied by changing the angle theta. So this theta, I can keep it as 0, I can make it as 45 degrees, or I can make it as 90, or it can be inclined at any angle. So by changing the value of theta, we can see that the value of sigma n is also going to change. And we can see that at certain angle of theta, this sigma n will become maximum. That maximum value of normal stress, we are going to call it as sigma 1, which is called as a maximum normal stress, or it is also called as a maximum principal stress. So what is a maximum principal stress? So maximum principal stress is a value of sigma n which is maximum. Similarly, when you keep on changing the value of theta, we get the value of sigma n as minimum at certain angle, and that minimum value of normal stress we are going to denote it by sigma 2, and which is called as minimum normal stress, or it is also called as a minimum principal stress. And these two stress, in general, they are called as a principal stresses. So principal stresses represent the maximum and minimum value of the normal stress on an inclined plane. So to get the value of sigma n maximum or minimum, we can make use of the slope condition. That is, if you differentiate the value of sigma n with respect to theta and if you equate it to 0, you will get the values of sigma n, sigma 1 and sigma 2. So the value of sigma 1 by using this equation, by using this mathematical condition, so if you differentiate this equation with respect to theta and if you equate it to 0, you will get the value of sigma n. So the value of sigma 1, you are going to get it as sigma x plus sigma y by 2 plus square root of sigma x minus sigma y by 2 whole square plus tau square. Similarly, when you differentiate this equation with respect to theta and equate to 0, you will also get the minimum value of sigma n, which we are denoting it as sigma 2, and this value will be equals to sigma x minus sigma y, sorry, sigma x plus sigma y by 2 minus square root of sigma x minus sigma y by 2 whole square plus tau square. So these two equation represents the equation for the maximum normal stress and the minimum normal stress, which are also called as the maximum principal stress and minimum principal stresses. After learning the concept of principal stresses, now let us see what is the meaning of the maximum and minimum shear stress. We know that when a given member is subjected to a biaxial stress system with shear on an inclined plane, the shear stress acting is given by the expression tau t will be equals to sigma x minus sigma y by 2 into sine of 2 theta minus tau into cos 2 theta. So in this expression, here the sigma x, sigma y and tau value, it remains constant and the only variable parameter is theta. Now, if I keep on varying the value of theta, the value of tau t is going to vary. So when the value of tau t is going to vary at certain angle theta, the value of tau t, it will become a maximum, and that maximum value of tau t, we are going to call it as tau max, which is nothing but the maximum shear stress. Maximum shear stress. Similarly, when you keep on varying the value of theta, at certain value of theta, the value of tau t will turns out to be a minimum, and this minimum value of tau t, we are going to call it as tau minimum, which represents the minimum shear stress. Now, how to get the value of the maximum shear stress and how to get the value of the minimum shear stress? So, in order to get the value of maximum shear stress and minimum shear stress, as we know that the tau t is mainly depending upon theta, we need to differentiate the tau t value with respect to theta and we should equate it to 0. So when you differentiate tau t with respect to theta and if you equate it to 0, then we will get two values for tau t. One is a minimum value and another one is a maximum value. So the minimum value, by differentiating this equation, we are going to get it as square root of sigma x minus sigma y by 2 whole square plus tau square. Similarly, the minimum value of tau t we are going to get by differentiating this equation with respect to theta and equating it to 0 is minus of square root of sigma x minus sigma y by 2 whole square plus tau square. So this is the value of the minimum shear stress which we are going to get. So these are the expression for the maximum and minimum shear stress, when a given member is subjected to a biaxial stress system with shear. After learning what is the principal stresses and what is the maximum shear stress and minimum shear stress, now let us see what is the meaning of the principal planes and its directions. So we know that the normal stress that is acting on an inclined plane, it is given by sigma x plus sigma y by 2 plus sigma x minus sigma y by 2 into cos 2 theta plus tau into sine of 2 theta. So when you differentiate this sigma n with respect to theta and if you equate it to 0, we will get two values of sigma n, and one value we are going to call it as sigma 1 and other value we are going to call it as a sigma 2. So sigma 1 represents the maximum normal stress and sigma 2 represents the minimum normal stress. So the plane on which sigma 1 is acting, so the plane on which sigma 1 will be acting, that plane is called as a principal plane, a maximum principal plane. Similarly, the plane on which sigma 2 stress acting, that plane is called as a minimum principal plane. So the principal plane represents the plane on which the normal stresses, the maximum normal stress and minimum normal stresses are acting. So we get the plane, the maximum normal stress plane, it will be acting at an angle theta p1 and it will be equals to half of tan inverse of 2 tau divided by sigma x minus sigma y. Similarly, the plane in which sigma 2 will be acting, it is always 90 degrees plus theta p1. So for theta p1, if you add 90 degrees, you will get the inclination of the plane where the minimum principal stress. Similarly, the maximum shear stress, it will be acting on a plane theta s1, which is inclined at an angle of theta s1, and it can be calculated by adding 45 degrees to theta p1. Similarly, the minimum shear stress, it will be acting on a plane which is inclined at an angle theta s2, and it will be equals to 135 degrees plus theta p1. So the angle theta p1, theta p2, theta s1 and theta s2 represents the direction or the inclination at which these planes are located with respect to the vertical. After learning the theoretical concepts of the analysis of stress and strain, now let us solve some of the problems on these concepts. So before solving the problems, first let us list down the various formulas we come across till now. So first formula we come across is the expression for the normal stress acting on an inclined plane when a given member is subjected to biaxial stress system with shear. So this normal stress on an inclined plane, we have denoted it by sigma n, and it is given by sigma n will be equals to sigma x plus sigma y by 2 plus sigma x minus sigma y by 2 into cos of 2 theta plus tau into sine of 2 theta. Similarly, we derived the expression for the tangential stress which is acting on an inclined plane when a member is subjected to a biaxial stress system with shear, and we denoted it by tau t, and we got the expression for tau t as sigma x minus sigma y by 2 into sine of 2 theta minus tau into cos of 2 theta. Similarly, we learnt what is the meaning of the principal stresses, and we found that there are two principal stresses. One is the maximum principal stress, or it is also called as a maximum normal stress, and it is denoted by sigma 1. So the value of sigma 1 we found to be sigma x plus sigma y by 2 plus square root of sigma x minus sigma y by 2 whole square plus tau square. Similarly, we found the expression for the minimum principal stress. It is also called as a minimum normal stress, and it is denoted by sigma 2, and we got the expression for sigma 2 as sigma x plus sigma y by 2 minus square root of sigma x minus sigma y by 2 whole square plus tau square. Next, we found the expression for the maximum and minimum shear stress. So maximum or minimum shear stress, and we can denote it by tau max or tau minimum. So the expression for tau max or minimum, it will be plus or minus square root of sigma x minus sigma y by 2 whole square plus tau square. So after finding the expression for the normal stresses on inclined plane, tangential stress on inclined plane, maximum principal stress, minimum principal stress, maximum and minimum shear stresses, we learnt what is the direction in which these stresses will be acting. That we represented it as principal planes directions. So the plane on which sigma p1 acting, it will be inclined at an angle which will be designated as theta p1, and it will be equals to half of tan inverse 2 tau divided by sigma x minus sigma y. Similarly, theta p2, it represents the angle of the plane on which the stress, minimum principal stress sigma 2, it will be acting, and we get theta p2 by adding 90 degrees to theta p1. Similarly, the maximum shear stress, it will be acting on a plane which is inclined at an angle theta s1, and in order to get the value theta s1, we should add 45 degrees to theta p1. Similarly, to get the plane on which the minimum shear stress acting, so which is denoted it as, which is denoted as theta s2, it can be found by adding 135 degrees to theta p1. So if you do so, we will get the direction of all the four planes on which the sigma 1, sigma 2, tau max and tau minimum will be acting. And if you observe all the equations which are here, all the equations, they will be consisting of only few parameters, that they are, one is sigma x, which represents the normal stress acting on the x direction, and we'll be finding sigma y, which represents the normal stress that will be acting in y direction, and it will be having tau, which represents the shear stresses, and we will be having theta, which represents the inclination of the inclined plane with respect to the vertical. So in all the four equations, it will be having only these four terms. So from the given diagram, if you could able to find all the four terms, then we can get these values easily. After learning the theoretical concepts in analysis of stress and strain, now let us try to solve some problems. So the first problem given is like this. The state of stress at a point in a strained member is as shown in the figure. We need to determine the normal stress and the tangential stress acting on a plane which is inclined at an angle of 60 degrees. Then we need to find the maximum principal stress, maximum principal stress, minimum principal stress, and then the direction of the maximum principal plane and the minimum principal plane. Similarly, we need to find what is the value of the maximum and minimum shear stress and the plane on which the direction of the plane on which the maximum and minimum shear stresses are acting. Along with that, we need to sketch the maximum principal plane, minimum principal plane, maximum shear stress plane, and minimum shear stress plane. So the given diagram is like this. So from the diagram, first we need to extract the data. So while writing the list of formulas, we saw that all the formulas, they will be having in common sigma x, sigma y, tau, followed by theta. So from the given diagram, first we need to extract those data. So once you extract the values of sigma x, sigma y, tau, and theta, then by making use of formulas, we can calculate the required values. So first, I am going to write the data. So first, data given is, so you can see here, the normal stress that will be acting in the x direction, it is given as 180 Newton per mm square. So the normal stress is denoted by sigma, and in x direction, if it is acting, then it is denoted by sigma x, and it will be equals to 180 Newton per mm square. So since it is tensile in nature, we are going to denote it by positive sign. Similarly, you can see that on the y direction, there will be a normal stress of magnitude 120 Newton per mm square. So the normal stress, it is denoted by sigma in y direction. So it is denoted as a sigma y. So the value of sigma y, it is 120 Newton per mm square. So it is tensile in nature. So I should put the plus sign in front of 120 Newton per mm square. Similarly, here the member is subjected to a shear stress of 180 Newton per mm square. We know that the normal stress effect is to either the increase in length or to decrease the length of the member. Similarly, the effect of shear stress is to rotate a member. So the rotation, it can be done either in counterclockwise direction or in clockwise direction. So in order to see what is the direction of rotation, we need to consider what is the shear stress that are acting on the vertical edges. So the shear stress that are acting on the vertical lines, if they are going to rotate the member in counterclockwise direction, then we consider them as positive. Suppose on the given member, if the shear stress that are acting on the vertical lines, if they are going to rotate the member in clockwise direction, then we can consider those shear stress as negative. So counterclockwise shear stress, they are considered as positive, and the clockwise shear stresses, they are considered as negative. Here in this diagram, this member is subjected to the shear stress that are going to rotate the member in counterclockwise direction. So we can take the value of tau as positive. And while deriving the expression for sigma n and tau t, we consider the value of theta with respect to vertical, and it will be in counterclockwise direction. So here the value of theta given, it is also with respect to vertical, and theta is measured in counterclockwise direction. So we can take the value of theta as 60 degrees positive. Suppose if they give the value of theta, if it is measured with respect to the vertical line itself, but if it happens to be measured in clockwise direction, then the value of theta will be taken as negative. But here, with respect to the vertical, the theta, it is measured in clockwise direction. So we are going to consider the value of theta as positive. So first step in solving a problem is to write the data by making use of the given diagram. So once you write the data by making use of the given diagram, now let us try to calculate what are the values which are required. So the first value which is asked is, we need to find the value of the normal stress and the tangential stress on a plane which is inclined at an angle of 60 degrees. So first I should find the normal stress and tangential stress which are acting on a plane which is inclined at an angle of 60 degrees. So to calculate the normal stress on an inclined plane, we'll be using the formula sigma n will be equals to sigma x plus sigma y by 2 plus sigma x minus sigma y by 2 into cos 2 theta plus tau into sine of 2 theta. Now substitute the values of sigma x, sigma y, tau and theta. So the value of sigma x given is 180, sigma y is 120. The value of sigma x, 180 minus 120 divided by 2 into cos of 2 times 60 degrees plus the value of tau given is 80 into sine of 2 into 60 degrees. So by solving this equation, you will get the value of sigma n, and you will get the value of sigma n as 204.28 Newton per mm square. Now let us try to find the value of the tangential stress acting on the inclined plane. So in order to calculate the tangential stress acting on the inclined plane, we will be using the formula sigma x minus sigma y by 2 into sine of 2 theta minus tau into cos of 2 theta. Now substitute the values of sigma x, sigma y, theta and tau in this equation. So sigma x is 180, sigma y is 120, sine 2 times 60 minus the value of tau is 80 into cos of 2 times 60 degrees. So when you solve this equation, we will get the value of tau t, and we get the value of tau t as 65.98 Newton per mm square. I am going to write these values here. So the value of sigma n, we got it as 204.28 Newton per mm square. Similarly, we'll get the value of tau t as 65.98 Newton per mm square. So after finding the values of sigma n and tau t, next we need to find what is the values of the principal stresses and the planes on which they are going to act. So the second thing we need to find is principal stresses and their directions. So we are having two principal stresses. So the first principal stress is sigma 1, which is called as a maximum principal stress. And to calculate the value of sigma 1, we will be using the formula sigma x plus sigma y by 2 plus square root of sigma x minus sigma y by 2 whole square plus tau square. So the value of sigma x given is 180, sigma y given is 120 divided by 2 plus square root of 180 minus 120 by 2 whole square plus 80 square. So if you solve this equation, you will get the value of sigma 1, and you will get the value of sigma 1 as 235.24 Newton per mm square. So after finding the value of sigma 1, now let us try to calculate what is the value of minimum principal stress, which is sigma 2. So to calculate the value of sigma 2, we can make use of the formula sigma x minus sigma y by 2 minus square root of in bracket sigma x minus sigma y by 2 whole square plus tau square. So the value of sigma x, again it is 180, sigma y is 120 divided by 2 minus square root of 180 minus 120 divided by 2 whole square plus 80 square. So if you solve this equation, you will get the value of the minimum principal stress, and the value of minimum principal stress, you are going to get it as 64.6 Newton per mm square. So once you find the values of sigma 1 and sigma 2, now let us try to calculate what is their direction. So in order to find the directions, we are having the formulas. So the plane on which sigma 1 is acting, it is inclined at an angle of theta p1, and to calculate the value of theta p1, we can make use of the formula half into tan inverse of 2 tau divided by sigma x minus sigma y. So half into tan inverse of 2 into tau is 80, the value of sigma x is 120, value of sigma y is 120. So if you solve this, you will get the value of theta p1, and the value of theta p1, you are going to get it as 34.72 degrees. Once you get the value of theta p1, we can calculate theta p2 easily by adding 90 degrees to theta p1. So add 90 degrees to theta p1, which is 34.72. So add this, you will get it as 24.72 degrees. So whatever the values of sigma 1, sigma 2, theta p1, theta p2 I got, I'm going to write it over here. So sigma 1 I got it as 235.24 Newton per mm square, and the value of sigma 2 I got it as 64.6 Newton per mm square. So the value of theta p1 I got it as 34.72 degrees, and theta p2 I got it as 124.72 degrees. So after finding the values of the sigma n, tau t, and sigma 1, sigma 2, theta p1, and theta p2, now let us go to the case 3, where I need to find the maximum and minimum shear stresses. Along with that, I should find the direction of the planes on which these stresses will be acting. So the maximum shear stress and minimum shear stress, it can be calculated by making use of the formula plus or minus in bracket square root of in bracket sigma x minus sigma y by 2 whole square plus tau square. So plus or minus the value of sigma x 180 minus 120 by 2 whole square plus the value of tau square is 80. So the value of maximum or minimum shear stress, we are going to get it as 85.44 Newton per mm square. Now let us try to find what will be the inclination of the plane on which the maximum shear stress will be acting, and it is denoted by theta s1, and we can get the value of theta s1 by adding 45 degrees to theta p1. So we got the value of theta p1 as 34.72. so if I add 45 degrees to 34.72, I will get it as 79.72 degrees. Similarly, the inclination of the plane on which the minimum shear stress acting, it is calculated by adding 135 degrees to theta P1. So theta P1 is 34.72 degrees. For that, if I add 135 degrees, I will get the value of theta S2 as 169.72 degrees. So here I am going to write the values which I have got. So but tau max or tau minimum, I got it as plus or minus 85.44 Newton per mm square, and I got the value of theta S1 as 79.72 degrees and theta S2 as 169.72 degrees. So once you find these values, the last step or the last parameter I need to find is I need to sketch the planes. So in order to sketch the planes, I need the values of theta P1, I need the value of theta P2, and then I need the value of theta S1 as well as theta S2. So we know that the angles, they are always measured with respect to the vertical line, and it is measured in counterclockwise direction. So first plane is theta P1, it is inclined at an angle of 37.42. So with respect to vertical, I will measure an angle of 34.72, and which is theta P1. So this plane, it represents the maximum principal stress plane. Now we can get the angle at which the minimum principal stress plane will be acting. So it will be 90 degrees plus theta P1. So here we are having theta P1. For that, if I add 90 degrees, I will get the plane where the minimum principal stress will be acting. Similarly, to get theta S1, it is 79.72. So theta S1, it is acting in this plane. So this is maximum shear stress plane. And to get the minimum shear stress plane, add 90 degrees to this theta S1. So when you add 90 degrees to theta S1, you will get theta S2, and this line represents the plane where the minimum shear stress will be acting. So this is a minimum shear stress plane, and this diagram represents the sketch of the various planes. So this completes the problem.